We shopped at Abercrombie online, in store, to figure out which way was best.
Are you ready for another episode of Mall Haul?
What? Where am I? This is incredible.
You look so freaking cute, Jackie.
What? Abercrombie definitely has had a major glow up. Mm-hmm. So you know we had to do a little investigation, go inside and see what this new glow up is all about.
We had to do it,
we
Jackie.
We had to, we do it for you.
Thank you so much.
We bought entire looks in store and online, and we are gonna see which experience we liked better. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so when comparing the two, we had to break down the differences, right? So online, in store, when it comes to diversity,
were there better sales online? Were there more sales in store? Was it easier to navigate the sales section in store?
Are you leisurely shopping online? Is it easier or is it easier in store? And then it comes down to time. Which one takes longer? Which one was faster when it comes to shopping online? Or shopping in store.
Let's get the party started.
Let's get the party started.
I was actually really excited to shop at Abercrombie because I personally haven't shopped there since high school. My number one thing that I really wanted to try was their Curve line.
Yeah, the Curve Love.
Curve Love.
Yeah.
I've actually had a lot of clever fans hit me up on Instagram being like, Jackie, you need to try the Curve Love. They'll fit you really well. So that was definitely my mission when shopping online. So there was a lot of comments on this pair.
Okay, let's see.
A lot of people said that they really loved it. This is from the Curve Love. It's the 90 straight leg jeans. I was surprised by the fit, okay? Because again, shopping for jeans online are very tricky. I've never bought a pair of Abercrombie jeans as of late, so I went with the 29, and honestly, like, the length is great. They're high-waisted like I like. There is a little bit of a bug out, but not like how I'm used to. So I was so shocked that I actually purchased these online and they fit.
It's a miracle.
I got this medium bodysuit, which was $39. Loved the color. I thought it was beautiful, but it is a little loose. I'm like, wait a minute, because a medium for me is true to size.
Yeah.
It's a little loose, so you can do a smaller size or a bigger size, whatever your comfort level is. I thought it was really cute, and I wanted to put a whole outfit together, so I was like, let me figure out if there's like a jacket or a shirt. I came across this $120 jacket. So expensive, oh my gosh.
You look so freaking cute, Jackie. Like,
thank you.
It's like too cute almost.
So I had a really good experience online shopping. I already prefer online shopping because I do this thing where everything I think is cute, I open into a new tab. And so I have like 90 tabs usually sometimes, but then it helps narrow down. The jeans were obviously like the focus. Mm-hmm. It's all I see on TikTok all the time is like everyone's shopping Abercrombie jeans. But online I noticed a bunch of new like girly floral stuff, which actually surprised me because I feel like we've also taken a huge shift into like dressing more tomboy. So I thought that was really interesting. I liked the online setting, especially for jeans, because they sell a long version of like, I think all of their jeans, Curve Love and non-Curve Love. Mm-hmm. And you don't find long like ever. And so getting it, being able to like select the exact jeans you want, the wash you want, the rips you want, they have all this variety. You can like find your perfect match. Mm-hmm. That was my favorite part.
It could be very specific,
very
like
specific.
this, and then your jeans are
there.
You're
not settling. Like, you feel like you saw everything. And then for the website, I noticed they definitely had a lot more variety. They had like different tops. They had different little camis, little bralettes, like a lot of accessories. I really liked that. I saw this shirt and I'm a sucker for a mesh moment.
I love it.
Especially in black. It's like, am I 90s? Am I Cher Horowitz?
You're totally Cher right now.
Oh my God, I'm totally bugging.
And then they also had this cute little bralette underneath, which like,
so cute.
I'll unbutton because it's actually, I swear, could dupe as like a little tank top or something.
Oh, she's scandalous.
This bralette was $29, my top was $40, and my jeans were $99.
And these fit you perfectly.
No, these fit me perfectly.
Like, they sit on your waist phenomenally, and I love how they just like go down so straight. These look great.
I'm obsessed with these jeans.
Yeah.
I finally figured out my right size. I'm usually a 28, and these are a 27 in the Curve Love, so they fit tighter around the waist, but they give you more room for all this other stuff, and then the length, like, drool. I'm drooling.
I get it.
Ew.
For me, I feel like the shopping experience was easy and fast. Mm-hmm. I knew kind of what I wanted, and once I found the jeans, the top and the jacket, you know, came in really quickly. So I feel like my experience, I want to give it like a 4 out of 5. It was thorough, it was quick. I saw what I liked and I put it in the cart.
Yeah.
And it was like easy breezy.
I'm gonna give my experience a 5.
Oh, wow.
I felt like there was variety, but there wasn't too much. I didn't feel like the way it was fast fashion where you have like endless amounts, mm-hmm. like a Cheesecake Factory menu. It was like, okay, here's our favorite selected, curated thing. Mm-hmm. Give it a 5.
Oh, I love you so much.
All right, guys, we are now wearing our in-store Abercrombie looks. Very different.
Yeah.
For me, I saw all the jeans and I kind of wanted to go a different route because I knew I did jeans online. Mm-hmm. So I saw these shorts and I have been wearing shorts like this more recently. And I thought these looked really fun and actually they fit well. They're really comfortable.
Summer's right around the corner.
And Abercrombie knows it. Well, spring, because everything was spring as heck.
It really was. Tell
you. You know, it has the same Abercrombie scent and music volume.
Abercrombie, bitch.
But I felt like the clothing was so different in store.
Oh, yeah.
It was like so springtime and youthful, but at the same time, farmer's market mom energy.
Yeah.
That was harsh, but accurate.
I was just shocked in general. I didn't know what store I was stepping into.
Right.
Just the layout too of how they presented their clothes. Very chic and very elevated.
Okay, and the dressing room?
Can we talk about the dressing room? I was like, where am I
like
right now?
Like a club. Like you could choose the type of lighting you wanted. It was like, do you want like soft sunshine? Do you want like moonlight rain?
The light's so magical.
Yeah. So I saw this top. I thought it just looked like really fun and interesting. I'm not obsessed with this top. I think overall the variety was not there in store for me today. Price-wise, I felt like in store was pretty similar. I did notice there was more like a visual sale section. Yeah. So I could really like put my hands on everything and there was a ton of winter stuff already on sale.
Yeah.
But if you like shopping sale and having everything like visually, I did feel like it was more enticing in store. The biggest thing I will say, the sizing in store was not there for me.
Mm.
For jeans especially, because I did wanna see if they had like a long version. They only had, at least what I saw, regular and short.
Very limited section. I don't know, I just feel like they just didn't have a lot in stock. Yeah. Overall, yeah. In this store. I was like you, I wanted to veer away from jeans, but I couldn't because all of like the slacks or bottoms that I did want to choose, they just didn't have my size.
Yes, I know, it's almost like, I don't know if that's a supply chain issue, if they're not able, or if they're just selling out like hotcakes in store. Yeah. Also got a pair of sandals.
Fun.
I was in store and I was like, you know what, these are actually really classy. I wouldn't have gravitated towards sandals at all online, so I think there was something about the experience in store. I saw them, I grabbed them, I got them.
Wow. What a story.
When I first walked in, everything is just laid out for you to see right when you walk in. So it was just all laid out and it was very easy. Like, okay, if I want jeans, go here. Yep. If I want a top, go here. So I thought that was really nice about the in-store shopping experience. But when it came to jeans, I feel like this makes it complicated. When you're online, you're looking at the reviews, you're clicking all the buttons to get the perfect size. Whereas when you're in the store, you're like, I need to try on every single pair. I literally tried on, I think, 6 jeans.
Oh my God, I'm sweating for you.
Is it hot in here?
I too got the 90s low rise baggy jeans.
Let me see.
And listen, I love the look of it.
Yes.
But then when you turn around, it's like, where'd she go? Because it's not even about like not seeing my butt, it just, my butt looks like flat and sad.
Sure.
This is what I like about shopping at Abercrombie. Like online, it seemed very like one note in a sense. And then when you go in the store, you get something that's a little bit more tomboy and relaxed.
I feel like we look like we shopped at 2 different stores, but I felt like I couldn't find anything tomboy and that's what I wanted.
Oh, so interesting.
Maybe I just didn't give it enough time.
I'm so jealous.
Okay, rating 1 through 5 for the in-store experience, I'm gonna go a 2.
Oh, snap.
Yeah, I mean, and the 2 comes from the dressing room alone. Like, the dressing room experience was, I felt like I was in Xenon.
Phenomenal.
Yeah, it was like futuristic.
Yeah.
But I really was bummed because I wanted to like see variety with pants and it was just lack of sizes. But I have noticed that over the years that they don't tend to like re-up on the long ones.
Mm-hmm. You know, I wanna give this a 5 only because I haven't been to an Abercrombie store in 10 plus years.
Sure.
So I think the experience for me going in there and seeing how different it was and how everything was laid out and the dressing rooms and stuff, I actually enjoyed shopping in store. And although I was trying on a bunch of different jeans, I didn't necessarily mind it because every time I went into the dressing room, it felt very comfortable.
I guess there's not a clear winner because you and I both had pretty opposite experiences for like online versus in store. Like crazy.
But you know what, you guys? What? We did this again, but we did it with Hollister. So if you love this, come back and watch our Hollister video and maybe there will be a clear winner there.